Here we are again at the presidential office, Temple Trees, talking to what I believe perhaps is the real architect of this whole story. The Commonwealth Games bid, Sri Lanka Hambantota 2018, takes a huge effort. It's a mammoth effort, and stood next to me is the co-chairman of the Commonwealth Games bid and governor of the central bank. He's got two hats, so we'll talk about the one big hat first. Governor Cabral, thank you very much, sir. Nice to talk to you. Now, coming together, Hambantota 2018, like you said, maybe 3 months ago was a thought that started to grow. 2 years ago, an impossible thought. Today, reality.
Yeah, I think you said it all in your very nice way of summing it up. Yes, that's the story about Sri Lanka. You see, some time ago, nobody would have given us a chance. We wouldn't have dared to. But today, I think we believe in ourselves that we can deliver something like this. It's an extraordinary effort that we'll have to put in, we know. But that's what makes it interesting. One of the themes on which the president came into office was that he wants to make Sri Lanka the wonder of Asia. But there are a few things that we have done to show that. This is going to be yet another one of those, because we truly believe that Sri Lanka will stand united in the bid of this nature, stand united when it comes to constructing the games villages, stand united in training ourselves to compete. So all these are some things that we should be aspiring for as a nation, and we're happy that this gives us an opportunity to get to that, and that's important.
Governor Cabral, I believe this gives Sri Lanka the courage, seeing all of this come together. And as you said, it is just about getting the right people, the right time. But of course, the serious business of getting the votes canvassed is a different kettle altogether. How is that coming together?
Well, we got to persuade people to give us the opportunity. And to do that, we got to give them very solid reasons. So we will not take anyone for granted. We know that all of them need to take a very professional decision. And we respect that. And we would be working hard to convince them. But at the same time, you know, it's only 8 countries that have had the opportunity of hosting the Commonwealth Games so far. In 80 years.
It's been controlled by the powerhouses, very much so.
Well, you got to understand that those are the countries that have come forward and said, let us do it.
And have the wherewithal as well.
Absolutely. So now, by Sri Lanka coming forward and saying, okay, we are prepared to do it, and we would like to have an opportunity to do that, also would give inspiration to many other countries who would say, look, we can do it too. So that's what we want to convey, that message. And I think it's a very important message from the point of view of the Commonwealth. Because the Commonwealth is all about empowering other nations to see that they also rise up in the overall conditions that they have. And that this would give a brilliant opportunity for many other countries. And we do hope that we will have that opportunity, because we'll show them that it can be done.
Now, the president's vision for being the hub of Asia is a very serious thought that he has now propagated into much greater detail, with the likes of you, the architects, getting together as a co-chairman of the Commonwealth Games bid. But of course, it means that for Sri Lanka, the opportunity, not just for the Commonwealth Games bid or hosting the Commonwealth Games, it's also for the wider periphery of Sri Lanka. It is a massive economic boost.
Absolutely. See, we have come together in sport, we have come together in infrastructure development, and we believe that our unity and the way that we are progressing now, we've had enormous challenges in the economic field, and we've come through with reasonably good shape, good colors,
and still breathing
and breathing and breathing well.
Yes.
So that gives us the confidence to attempt other ventures. This is something that we would like to do. But it is done on the foundation of a solid economic structure that we have built for ourselves. The infrastructure has been regularly built up. Our macroeconomic fundamentals are benign. Even in the worst of crisis, we were able to absorb the shocks and see that the country does not have any major upheaval.
Well, we managed to stride past a lot of other nations who couldn't succumb.
Yeah, so I think it showed the spirit of the Sri Lankans, that we would work hard, that we would work smart, that we would deliver what is necessary. So I think in our bid, as well as if the bid is successful in the organizing of the games, we would be able to deliver. If you had considered some of the points that I made in my speech, I mentioned about 2016. People will say, but you're talking about 2018. No, we're talking about 2016. Because we want to convey the message that if we get the opportunity, we want to get everything ready by 2016. So that we'll have one clear year for purposes of training, and another year, at least the part of it, which will give us ample preparation time. So these have been thought through carefully. Already we are working on the basis as if we have got the bid, because we know we cannot in any way put by time, which we have to ensure that it is at the right time and the right peak. So we are working hard towards it, because the legacy that we are concerned about, the legacy of ensuring that the city is built and that the city is built on time and that city will be delivering the economic benefits to everyone, not only those who are in the city, but for the entire nation. So that's a very, very powerful factor which really energizes us.
Which is a grand thought. Now, you wear two caps, of course. The Commonwealth Games co-chairman is one. And then you were talking about the economy and the greater economy of Sri Lanka. As governor of the central bank, you have overseen, in more ways than one, the careful passage of Sri Lanka from very, very difficult times to fairly decent, strong position, a position that is a lot stronger than we were before. That gives us the momentum and the impetus to be able to say, look, we are good, we're strong. How does that make you feel as governor of central bank, stood in the place, here we are launching to the world? It must make your heart feel a little bit better.
Simply put, it does give me a lot of extraordinary satisfaction. See, but we did it with a lot of passion, but at the same time, we did it very, very carefully. We knew that our economy was not the best in the world. We had to build many spaces, many cushions within the economy. And we did just that. Because if you want to be able to deliver, you got to be strong yourself. I'm always reminded of this beautiful advertisement or the message that is conveyed to you when you get into an aircraft. When they show the oxygen
mask drops,
they say, first put it on yourself and then put it on your child. Because if you become breathless and you are trying to help your child,
you can't.
Same thing goes with the economy as well. You got to have your institutions strong. You need to see that your government is having the ability to do the certain economic endeavors that it should do. And if you do that, you'll probably find that the message gets around very, very quickly. So we just did that. We have to get the simple things right and to do the basics right. And that's what we did. And we'll continue to do that.
A wonderful formula from the governor of the central bank to keep it simple, keep it practical.
Thank you.
Get the courage, work together, and make it happen.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Blessings on this wonderful project.
Thank you. And thank you very much for all the help that you have given and the thoughts and ideas. We appreciate it very much.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
The governor of the central bank, co-chairman of the Commonwealth Games Bid Committee, is a very quiet, smiling man right now. But my goodness, how much of responsibility do you think he carries on his shoulders? A country turnaround, a country looking to bid for the Commonwealth Games, a flagship for 71 nations who will now take courage from Sri Lanka, my island, our paradise, on the way, showing the world that it can be done.